Good morning, everyone.
Good
Hi,
morning,
good morning.
Jeff.
Good morning. It's good to see you again. It's Friday. Any plans for the weekend? Do you have any plans for the weekend?
No, only sleep.
Honestly, that's a great plan, actually.
Yes. 48 hours.
It's the best one. All right, guys, let's start with today's session. We have for today's session, we continue to have the specific objective, state frequency of activities I do in my work. Like the specific one, but our class objective is to write a paragraph, okay? To write a paragraph about how often I do things at work. Okay, I'm sending you the class objective to your WhatsApp group, right? No, to this group right now, to the chat over here. All right.
What is the meaning of often?
What's the meaning of?
Often.
Frequency.
Often.
Of.
It's
frequency.
It's
same
like
of frequency.
Frequently. Frequently, right?
Frequently.
Frequently.
Thanks.
It's exactly the same. All right. Welcome, welcome. All right. So I'm sending you two pictures for you to discuss with the people in your group. We're going to start off today's session with a little group discussion. Okay. So that you guys get to know a little bit more about yourselves. Now, let's see. Let me send you the pictures. Right now. Let's see. Okay, all the questions start with how often, how often. We're talking about how frequently you do different activities in the questions over there. Here we go.
Hello, teacher. Everyone began ask, and another answer the questions.
Yes, you have to ask the questions in the pictures, and you guys give the answers.
Okay. I read the first. How often do you order delivery food?
Medardo and John William have to answer the questions.
Yes, yes. Solo que no sé qué significa.
Delivery food is like food from Pizza Hut, food from any restaurant, China Walk. So you order the food from your house.
I order food usually on Friday.
Hi, teacher.
Hello, how can I help you?
We forget the thing we have to do.
There are some pictures with questions in the WhatsApp group. You have to ask those questions to each other and you have to answer them.
Okay. Yeah, in the chat, write a paragraph about often I things.
That is today's class objective.
Okay. Sorry. I'm asleep yet.
Don't worry.
Okay.
I never run.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I never, me too.
I never. The other is, how often do you eat junk food?
Junk food.
Junk.
What is junk food?
Es comida rápida. Pupusas is junk food, true?
No, estoy segura, nunca había escuchado junk food.
Junk food is food that's not healthy. Like hamburgers, french fries, let's see, what
pizza.
Else? Pizza, yes.
Pizza.
Exactly, that's junk food.
Pupusa.
Hey, pupusa is junk food?
Yes.
I would say it is, because it's not so healthy.
Okay.
Once a week.
Disculpa.
Junk is... junk food is comida chatarra. Pero el significado de junk, no estoy segura, pero junk food es comida chatarra. Comida rápida.
Junk is chatarra.
Mm-hmm. Ah, okay. Junk is chatarra.
How often do you eat candies?
I rarely eat candies.
Okay. How often do you go to the doctor?
Normally go to the doctor when I am sick.
Okay, good.
Okay, my turn.
Okay.
How often do you order delivery food?
I occasionally order delivery food, maybe once a week, too.
Okay. How often do you run?
I seldom run. I do exercise in my at home.
Mm-hmm. Okay, me too. How often do you eat junk food?
I occasionally eat junk food.
How often do you drink?
I sometimes drink.
Okay.
Teacher, how do you pronounce vegetables? I don't know.
Exactly like that. Vegetables. Vegetables. Okay.
Vegetables.
Exactly.
I eat vegetables a la fuerza. how often? Ah, teacher, teníamos una duda.
Tell me.
How often do you travel? Is an internal or external?
It can be in any way.
Anyway, okay.
Yes, yeah. Both forms.
Always. I always eat vegetable. And you, Genaro?
Sorry.
It's fine. Usually it's based vegetable, but it depends of the food, because sometimes we eat like pasta.
Okay. How often do you travel again? How often do you wake up in the middle of the night?
Buenos días.
I never wake up in the middle of the
5%. Okay.
Sí.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we finish.
Okay.
Okay, next activity of today's session. We have an activity that's called unscramble the questions and sentences. Okay, what's the meaning of unscramble in English? Can you explain it to me? Unscramble.
Unscramble.
We have to organize something that's not organized or that's disorganized, right? Okay, so we say we have the following information over here. Okay, these are sentences and questions. Okay. So we have to put them in the correct order. We have to use every single word in every example. Okay, so we're working in groups and you guys are putting everything in the correct order. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, here we go. I'm sharing everything we do. Don't worry. Every time I send you to an activity, I send you the information. Don't worry.
Okay.
Thanks.
Creo que esa es la primera. Es what time? What time?
What time does she usually?
Hi, Emily.
Hi.
Creo que es what time usually. She does go to bed.
Yeah. What time does she usually go to bed? For the next one.
Next.
Next is, do you
drink?
Drink.
No, sorry. Is, do you have the dinner? Or do you have
potatoes?
Any
or salad?
Me disculpen que ahorita no puedo ver bien, me siento mal, pero bueno.
Do we have any lettuce for our salad? Luego sería, does your sister,
how often does?
Sí. How often does your sister?
Do
thing.
Do we have?
Do you or do
hello.
You? Do you have? Do you have any letters? Do we have any letters or salad? For what?
Strawberry. Ay, no, que fue un segundo. Any strawberry?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Next one.
How often?
How often does your sister work? On weekends.
Right.
Yes. How often does your sister work? On weekends. Yeah.
Okay. Y la última sería, what does sport he play?
Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so egg number one, what's the answer?
What time does she usually go to bed?
Wonderful. Very good. Very good. What's the answer for number two?
Do you ever have chicken for dinner?
Do you ever? Very good. Do you ever? Remember, it's a question when we want to know some information that we are not sure about. We usually have no idea about what the answer is. Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. Let's continue. For the next one, sorry. What's the answer for the next one? Number three. Number three is?
Don't we have any lettuce for our salad?
For our salad. Very good. Very good. What's number four?
How often does your sister work on weekends?
Awesome. Very good. On weekends. Very good. What's number five?
We did not need any strawberry for the cereal.
Wonderful. Very good. Everybody, repeat with me. We don't need. We don't need.
We don't need.
We don't need. We don't need.
Any straw. Any straw.
Any.
Any strawberry.
Strawberry.
Awesome. For the cereal. Very good. Okay.
For the cereal. Strawberry.
The next one. What's the next one?
Do they all watch play soccer in a soccer field?
Awesome. Very good. Play soccer in a soccer field. This next word over here, soccer, is an adjective. Mm-hmm. What type of field? Mm-hmm. Soccer field, right. And the last one is... What's the last one?
What sport he plays.
Okay. Everyone has this option as an answer?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
No, we have
sport he plays.
I want to know all the options. Okay, if you have a different option, you can say it. Let's see.
What sports
does he play?
Does he play?
Good. Okay, so yeah. Which is the right one? It's the second option. Look,
mm-hmm.
What sports? This word is similar to the word, to the question, what food do you like? Yes. What mm-hmm. music okay. do you like? So we will always have the type of information next to what? What music? Okay, what music? The information
music.
Next to what, right? Very good, very good. Okay, next activity, it says write questions for the answers. Okay, this one is a bit more complicated. So I'm showing you a set of answers here, okay? And you have to write the questions for the answers. So I'm sending you this over here, okay? And we're doing the first one all together so that you have an idea of what we're doing, okay? So for example, for the answer, no, she doesn't like chicken. What's the question to ask?
Does she like chicken?
Very good. So this is pretty much what we're doing. Okay. So you have to write the questions for every answer. Okay. Here we go.
Does she like the chicken? Does she like chicken? Chicken. Hi, Henaro.
Hi.
When do you play basketball?
Weekend.
How often?
How often?
How often?
Do you swim?
Do we swim?
Sí, pero le haríamos ahí week o solamente do we swim.
No, solamente do we swim.
Sí, ¿verdad?
I think next one. She's a nurse.
She's a nurse.
I'm thinking. Sería what she do. What does not have? I don't know.
Ustedes.
Ustedes,
You.
How often do you swim?
Okay, el número 5 sería.
How often practice?
How often, otra vez. How often?
If we want to know that she's a nurse. I don't know if you agree with me.
La número 5. How often? La 5 sería, how often do we practice sport?
Do we have fish for breakfast?
Okay, la número 8 sería.
They go with their parents. Ellos van con sus padres, ¿verdad? Pero
where do they go?
¿Cómo?
Where do they go? ¿Para dónde van?
They go with their parents.
No sería con quién van.
No sería who.
Eight,
Do you eat pork? Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you
eat, no, do you, I never eat pork.
¿Cómo les quedó la de they go with their parents?
Ajá. Who do you repeat este Jorge?
Mande.
Repeat. Pienso, ¿qué dijiste?
Is who go with them.
And our team.
Boston.
In la última sería, what time do you start to work?
¿Cómo es la
última? What time?
Okay, let's see. For answer number two, what is the correct question, Carlos, Eduardo? For answer number two.
Okay, is do you play basketball?
Take a look at the answer. The answer is we play basketball on weekends. Okay, so in my question, I need to make sure that I understand that the person already plays basketball, right? So since in the answer we have we play basketball on weekends, I need to have a specific WH question word in my question. So I say, when do you play basketball? I already know you guys play basketball. Or I can say, how often do you play basketball? And in the answer, we play basketball on weekends. Now, let's see. For the next one, for the answer, we go swimming once a week. What's the question, Medardo? We go swimming once a week.
How often do we swim?
Okay, how often do you swim? Very good. Let's see. Good. How often do you swim? We can say that. Or how often do you go swimming? It's a good option as well. Very good. For the answer, she is a nurse. What's the correct question, Aldo?
what does she or what are her profession?
Okay, very good. Let's see if we have another option. I want to listen to your options. John William, what question do you have?
What does she do?
Oh, okay. What does she do? All right. Any other different question? What's her job? What's her profession? Well, actually, those are good options. The main answer I was looking for was, what does she do? Every time that a person asks you, what do you do? What does she do? What do they do? They want to know your profession or your occupation. But we can also have some other options, like she is a nurse. Okay, so we can ask, what's her profession, right? Very good. We can also ask, what's her job position? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so those are two other options that we have. Very good, very good. For the answer, we practice sports 5 days a week. We practice sports 5 days a week. What question do you have, Beatrice?
How often do you practice sport?
Okay. In this one, how often? Because we have a number. It says we practice sports 5 days a week. Now, for the next one, yes, we sometimes have fish for breakfast. What's the question, Douglas?
How you ever have fish for breakfast?
Okay, very good. Let's see. Let's ask for some other options as well. Let's see. Leonel Merino, what option do you have? Sorry, can you repeat that?
Do you ever have fish for breakfast?
Okay, very good. Very good. All right, let's listen to some other options. Leonel Merino, what do you have?
How often do you eat pork?
Okay, listen. The answer says, well, it's the one about fish for breakfast, right? So, in the answer, the person says, yes, we sometimes have fish for breakfast. So, in the answer, I have some information that I didn't know, I was not sure about before. So, I just threw the question at the person. So, I say, do you ever, because it's not something common to have for breakfast, right? So I say, do you ever have fish for breakfast? So you got it right. Now, the next one says, no, I never eat pork. What options do you guys have? No, I never eat pork. What's the question for that answer?
Do you eat pork?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Do you eat pork? Okay. Other options?
Have you ever eaten pork?
Oh, if we ask questions with have you ever, we are using present perfect.
Mm-hmm.
The answer, the person says, yes, I have. No, I haven't. So it's it refers to you doing an action at some point in the past. Okay, so now if you want to ask about something that's a part of a person's routine or part of a person's life, we have to go with this question. Do you ever eat pork? Do you ever?
Do you ever eat pork?
Okay. Now, you said, do you eat pork? It's a valid option as well. Yes, it is a good option to ask. Do you eat pork? Do you ever eat pork? Now, we have, for the answer, they go with their parents. They go with their parents. What could be the question to ask? They go.
Who they go with?
Oh, okay. And you were saying? You said I have.
Who do they go with?
Who do they go with?
You got the right answer. Very good. Who do they go with?
Uh-huh. Who do they go with?
I heard another option over there. That's a good answer too. We can say, who goes with them? And it's good. Okay, who goes with them is option two. Who goes with them? Who goes with them? Okay. Now, who do they go with? Who goes with them? The second one is good too. Let's see. Our team practices every day. What's the question to ask?
How often does our team practice?
Does. Okay. The team. Listen. The team is
plural.
Oh, is it? Can I have one team, two teams, three teams, four teams?
Yes, but it means that it's a team. It's a thing.
We refer to it as a singular form. So that's why we say when does your team practice, or how often does your team practice applies to the question. You see, the team is a word that refers to something that's plural. You understand it. It's like saying family. It's like saying saying what else? Let's see, a group. Okay, you know it's a singular word, but it contains a plural context, right? Mm-hmm. But we conjugate it as something singular, right? So mm-hmm. when does your team, right? Okay, and the last one. I start work at 6:30 a.m. What's the question? What time do you start to work? Or what time do you start to work is a good option as well. Very good, very good. Okay, let's move on to our next activity. Okay. So for this activity, we're using our books here. Okay, and we're going to read a little. So it says, read about Mr. Wilson. Check the correct sentences and correct the wrong ones. It says, okay. So take a look at this. Okay, so we have, can you read the text for me? Let's see, we're gonna ask one person to read for us. And we're asking Francisco, help us read. Francisco Murillo.
Okay, hello, my name is John Wilson. I work in an office. I'm a human resources manager. Every day I check emails for the company. I always answer the phone and talk to potential employees. Generally, I attend meetings in the morning and not so often in the afternoon. In my company, we always have events. We have to attend a conference on July 21st, and then we have to attend a meeting about the conference on July 22, and I'm always busy.
Okay, very good, very good, very good. Okay, let's work on some details here. Let's see, we have these things, which are dates. Okay, for example, 21st. We say 21st and 22nd.
Yes,
okay. Today is Friday.
16th.
Friday 16th. Right?
Yes.
16th, right. Just remember, ordinal numbers usually finish with TH. And that's the only thing that changes. But when you have SD or ND, it's because you have the first three numbers. Okay, the first three numbers go as first,
second,
third, and third. Okay, so every time you go, you get to a big number, 30, first, 30,
second,
30,
third.
Okay, and then they all go with TH, 24th, 25th, 26th, sorry. Okay, so that's only for dates. Now, what do you think is incorrect in the text? Let's see. In the exercises, his name is John Wilkins. Well, the text doesn't have anything incorrect. The thing is that we're correcting the statements over here. So it says, his name is John Wilkins. Is it true or false?
False.
What's his name? Okay, very good. Very good. It says Wilson over here. Very good. He writes reports every day.
False.
What's the right information?
He checks email the company. In
answer phones.
Every day, right? Okay. He never answers he never answers the phone and talk to customers.
It's false.
It's false.
No, it's true. True. It's true because he answered the phone and talked with potential employees, not with customer.
Ah, okay. Very good. Very good. You got it there. Number four. He often attends meetings in the morning.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's true.
Yes, it's true.
Okay. Are you sure?
Meeting in the morning.
He often?
No. It's not often.
Often in the afternoon.
Okay. No, it's true. Oh. You see? Look.
True. I asked in the morning.
In the morning.
I'm not in the afternoon.
In the afternoon. Mm-hmm. It was correct.
Yes, it's true.
Okay. It's true. Now, it says, he never attends meetings in the afternoon. Never. It says never.
It's false.
It's false.
It's false.
False.
Because?
Oh, attends meetings in the morning.
He attends meetings in the morning?
And not often in the afternoon.
Not so often.
Meaning to say sometime in often. The afternoon.
So in the answer or in the correction, we can say he... Uh-huh. He doesn't often attend meetings in the afternoon. Like this, it's in the chat. Okay, let's see. The next one says, he usually has events in the company.
False.
What's the correct answer?
He always
has events in the company. Mm-hmm. He has to go to a conference on July 22nd.
Yes. True.
Are you sure?
July 22nd.
The conference was 21st.
Oh, the conference is on the 21st. And what's on the 22nd?
Meeting.
A meeting about what?
A meeting about the conference.
About the conference.
Mm. Okay. So the conference is one day before, right? And the conference on the next day, right? Very good. Okay. What do you guys have to do right now as a group? Okay. As a group, I want you to make a paragraph about the activities that you guys have to do at work and how frequently or how often you do those activities. Okay. Now, you can select one person in your group to write your paragraph, okay, and take that person's information to write your paragraph, or you can make it up, all right? You can invent it. Take it out from your imagination. So, are we okay with the instructions?
Yeah.
Yes, okay, so I'm sending you an example, this example to the group, okay? And it's your turn to write a paragraph using frequency adverbs and your activities at work. Here we go.
A story, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, my opinion is that
only Carlos, creo que nadie se llama Carlos de la clase.
Carlos Smith.
Carlos Smith.
Llevaron una combinación Smith, de salvadoreño con
y gringo.
Eso pensé. I work in.
Ya es democracia, Beatriz, así es que.
Dedocracia.
Muy bien. No, ya es mayoría calificada.
Ok, déjame, voy a escribir.
Ponga, tomemos un tema sobre el cual vamos a hablar y sobre ese imaginémonos cada uno un pedacito del párrafo para poder redactarlo un poco más rápido.
Okay.
Entonces, ¿sobre qué quieren hablar o algo que sea bastante fácil de escribir?
Quizás.
Yeah, we can say that.
Manager or.
You say I'm a chef.
I'm a chef. ¿Cómo sería chef? No sé, chef ejecutivo.
It's fine.
I'm chef. I am the principal chef. I wake up every day that I wake up every day at 4 at 5 a.m. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I wake up
at 5 a.m.
Quiero poner que tiene que abrir el restaurante a las 6, preparar el restaurante a las 6.
Because I need to. Open or it's something else like.
What is it?
¿Cómo?
Because the restaurant is open. The restaurant open.
Open at 6 or.
Because the restaurant open.
Six a.m.
6 a.m.
Open.
Yeah. Open at 6. Yeah.
Then.
Every day I prepare the main dish.
Voy a poner también, I normally meeting the, or attend the meeting.
Uh-huh, I normally attend the meeting. Attend meetings, nada más.
Attend meetings.
Luego sería.
Yes.
Okay.
I write to the office. I am a sales manager.
Manager.
Okay.
aquí ponemos lo del café. Always.
Sí.
Todas las mañanas.
Every day. Uh-huh.
All the morning.
Every
Often, every morning, I prepare my coffee or...
Cup of coffee.
My coffee.
And then...
I check my...
Emails. Or agenda. Y después que chequee los emails.
Okay.
Yes.
¿Cómo es? ¿Saben cómo es agenda?
Okay. I work up 9 p.m.
At 9 p.m.
Yes.
I start to work. Oh.
No, I start work at 1:30 p.m. And work up.
I leave work or I
yes.
work out.
Mm-hmm.
And this is I generally or always?
Always.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Lions era el que va seguido, ¿verdad? O era customer.
It's clients. Yes.
Okay.
The emails for the company. I usually supervise my coworkers. I normally attend meetings. I always be on time on my job. And I never lose the conferences. And sometimes I drink a cup of coffee when I'm working. Así sería, ¿no? Dime que quiero eliminar.
Digo que Grisel la lee.
Para que se anime.
Es que sí me siento cansada. Work.
Ah, work.
Ajá. From home. Meetings. I always be on time on my job. I never lose the conference, and sometimes I drink a cup of coffee when I'm working.
Thank you.
Buenos días.
All right, let's start checking your creations. We're going to start off with Emily, Genaro, John, John, and Medardo.
Okay. Solo leo.
You can take turns reading. One person can read from the group. You decide. And if you can, you can display your screen. It would be better.
Okay. So I will read the paragraph.
Okay. Yes.
Hello, my name is Bob Toronja and I work in a restaurant. I am the principal chef. I wake up every day at 5 a.m. because the restaurant opens at 6 a.m. I prepare the main dish every day. I wash the vegetables and select the best ingredients for dishes. Sometimes we have to make a special dessert like apple pie because it's the favorite of the client. I close the restaurant 10 p.m. and at 11 p.m. I go home.
Wonderful, wonderful example. Let's see. The restaurant opens, one more time. The restaurant opens at?
The restaurant opens at.
Awesome, very good. All right, great job. Thank you very much. Let's continue with Beatriz Garay, Cesar, Francisco, Jorge, and Karen. All right, select one person from the group and that person can start reading.
I didn't read. Okay, I read. I read to the office at 6 a.m.
I read.
I am a sales manager. Often in the morning I prepare my coffee and then I check my schedule. I always check my email. I usually attend the calls in the morning, but not so often in the night. Every Friday, I have the meeting with the important client for business development.
Good job. Very good. Very good. Let's repeat something again. I arrive. I arrive.
I arrive.
I arrive.
Okay. And then. Often in the morning, often in the morning.
Often in the morning.
Okay, so we just need to add in the, right? In the morning. Okay. Then, now, I just wanna make sure, a comment over here. You see why Friday has, is underlined in red? It's because in English, if you are writing days of the week, they have to go with capital letters. Okay, so that's the correction. That's why it shows you the word underlined in red. But other than that, it's great. Very good job. Very good. Thank you very much.
Sure.
Let's continue. Tell me.
I have a question. It's necessary mm-hmm. In the when I talk about me, use I, for example. I arrive, I attend, I walk.
If you want to mention all the activities at once, like making a list of activities, okay, you can just mention I the first time and then you just continue. Okay, for example, you say, okay, in my job, I attend meetings, I check exams, I work on evaluations, and then you continue, right? You say, I. But you can do it the other way. You say, in my job, I make evaluations, attend meetings, check exams, okay? And you give a list of activities that you do. But You can do it if you don't break the chain. Okay, if you don't break the chain of information. But if you include a different type of information, you have to start with I all over again.
Okay, thanks.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Now let's continue with Aldo, Griselda, and I don't know if there was anyone else in the group.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Aldo and Griselda.
Okay. I will read it. So I didn't write the information on my cell phone. I write on my notebook. Okay, hello, my name is Carlos Smith. I work in a bank. I'm a customer service manager. I always call customer and check the email for the company. I usually supervise my coworking and normally I attend meeting. I always be on time on my job. I never lose the conferences and sometimes I drink a cup of coffee when I'm working.
Okay, very good, very good. Very good job. I just want to make two observations.
Okay.
Always on time. Okay, now they're in the chat. The first one is about pronunciation. So we say, I attend meetings.
Meetings.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I attend meetings.
And the second one is, I'm always on time. We conjugate the verb to be, right?
Okay.
Other than that, it was great. Very good. Okay. And our last group is Carlos, Douglas, Elizabeth, and Olga. 3, 2, 1, action.
Who wants to read? I read.
I think you can read.
Okay, I read.
Okay.
Hello, my name is Elizabeth Martinez. I am a consultant in a call center. I always work from home. I every day change flights and routes. I always give the information about customers' reservation. I get in a special service for the reservation, for example, animals, wheelchair, or a snack. I always confirm flights. I sometimes offer country restriction. I always leave work at 9 p.m. I am always busy.
All right, this is great. Very interesting. Let's see. I am a consultant in a call center. Okay, do you remember that there are some frequency adverbs that only go at the end of the sentence? Well, every day is one of them. Every day, once a week and twice a week, they go at the end of the idea. So we say, I change flights and routes every day.
Okay.
Okay. I always give the information about customers' reservations. Repeat it with me.
Reservations.
Okay. I get special services.
Special services.
For the reservation. For animals. For the reservation for animals. For example. And then, for example, at the end. Mm-hmm. So, for animals.
For example.
Mm-hmm. And then, for example. For the reservation for animals, for example. For example, yes.
For animal, for example,
mm-hmm. Wheelchairs or snacks. Oh, no. Give me a second.
For example, I get
special
service
of everything. Yes, at the end of everything. Yes.
The special service are animals, wheelchairs. Or it's not.
For example,
at the end. Mm-hmm. Just cut it and paste it at the end.
Snacks.
After snacks, yes.
For example.
There you go.
Yes.
I was going for flights. Okay. Country restrictions in plural. Country restrictions.
Countries.
No, just country restrictions. Pronunciation for restrictions with S. Country restrictions.
Restriction.
Restrictions.
Without
okay,
the S.
One more time. Restriction. With the with S. The S. You have to make the S sound. Restrictions. Okay, very good. And that was great. Very good job. Very good. Okay. Thanks. Overall questions. Questions about today's session. Overall questions. Any question comes to your mind? Any question?
No.
No? Mm-mm. Okay. So if there are no questions, I'm going to see you on Monday. Now, I already activated homework assignments. Have you checked in Schoology?
I couldn't find it. Can you explain me again?
Yes. Give me a second.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Sure. No problem. I'm opening my Schoology account. Upcoming. Okay. So if you do it from your,
from my phone,
your computers. Okay. If it's from your computer, this is what you see, right? Mm-hmm. Now, here you have a little calendar that says upcoming. Oh, okay. So if the due date, you see the due date, the first activity, the due date for the first activity is on October 18th. Okay. And the other ones are for Sunday. No, sorry. Yes. No. Saturday 17 is the first one. Mm-hmm. Sunday, October 18 is the second and third one. Okay. So, it is October 16th right now. Mm-hmm. So you have 2 days to finish the activities. Okay. So if the due date is still on, you will see your activities here where it says upcoming. Si todavía no se ha caducado la tarea, la fecha de la tarea, le sale acá. Mm-hmm. Si no, if you want to do your homework, but it's late already, you have to go to week one, okay, to the folder. Homework assignments, you click on homework assignments and you have the assignments here. Okay. Mm-hmm. So all the homework assignments are here in the same folder. Okay. Algunas personas prefieren irse directo a la tarea, a la semana y abrir la carpeta de las tareas porque ya aparecen todas. Mientras la tarea no haya caducado, aparece en la pantalla principal. Ahora bien, si usted está en su teléfono, les voy a mandar una captura de pantalla desde la cuenta acá en mi teléfono. Ok, vamos a ver. Vaya, en sus teléfonos, ustedes ven eso en la pantalla principal. Ahorita les mando un screenshot. Vaya, ustedes entran al curso y ven eso en la pantalla principal. Cuando hay alguna tarea, ustedes le dan clic ahí donde dice por venir. Ahorita les mando captura también. Okay. Entonces ahí pueden ver donde dice por venir y le dan clic y ahí están todas las tareas mientras no haya caducado la fecha de entrega. Ahora bien, yo comprendo que a veces su tiempo de trabajo les interfiere un poco con la entrega de tareas. Entonces, pueden entregarme tareas ya con fecha ya caducada, no hay problema, pero solamente si ustedes tienen algún inconveniente. Entonces, me tienen que decir por qué han tenido que entregar la tarea ya con una fecha posterior a la fecha límite y pues yo puedo comprender diferentes situaciones, ¿verdad? Pero lo ideal es que ustedes me entreguen las tareas en la fecha límite para que eso no les interfiera ya al momento de finalizar el módulo. Okay. Entonces, y para la entrega de tareas, no les he mandado el video todavía, ¿verdad?
¿Cómo no?
Ya se los mandé. Ah, ok.
Sí.
Vale, entonces, vean los videos, van a ver ahí que es bien fácil entregar tareas y si tienen algún problema, entonces me llaman, me escriben.
Teacher, pero estoy verificando aquí este que dice por venir y dice entrega el 17, no el 18, dice. Uh-huh. Pero eso del simple present que no lo hicimos la semana pasada.
Ah, pero si usted ya lo entregó, está bien.
pero no sé si está bien porque yo no pude modificar la página, ¿cómo se llama? El PDF no lo pude modificar tampoco en Word, entonces tuve que hacerlo en el cuaderno y mandar una foto. Sí, pero es... hubo algo que no comprendí de la tarea y quedé un poco confundida, porque entiendo que lo que teníamos que hacer era leer y luego, bueno, abajo no dice las indicaciones, pero entendería que abajo verificar si es cierto que Alfred es an American boy. Pero, por ejemplo, en la opción 2, no le entendía a qué se refería porque solamente le pone modem, older, starts, lives, begin, together, pero no entendía a qué se referían esas palabras, sinceramente.
Vamos a ver.
Tenías que marcar.
Ahí
dice, como un cruce, un match.
Antónimos, creo que decía.
Vaya, aquí dice antónimos. ¿Qué son los antónimos? ¿Qué es un antónimo?
Como lo opuesto.
Es lo opuesto.
Lo contrario.
Entonces vamos a ponerlo junto. Entonces vamos a decir que el antónimo de happy tiene que ser
unhappy,
¿verdad? El antónimo de older es
younger.
Bueno, aquí la primera actividad es solo elegir true or false. Segunda es match the words. Y en la tercera es contestar las preguntas. Vale, ahora usted ha tocado un punto muy importante. Si usted no puede modificar un archivo PDF o no puede modificar Word, entonces usted descarga el archivo y lo puede imprimir, o usted agarra una hoja de papel y solo me pone número uno y las respuestas van ahí. Entonces le toma foto y eso es lo que va a cargar a Schoology.
Ah, ok.
Usualmente, si es PDF, ahí le da una opción para poderlo modificar. Medardo y Douglas tienen preguntas. Comenzamos con Medardo.
Ok, gracias. Dos preguntitas nada más. Esa parte tampoco la pude hacer de la tarea porque no la entendí. O sea, si la cargué, ¿todavía la podemos modificar?
Sí, la pueden modificar. Todavía la pueden modificar.
Ok, y le enviamos un nuevo archivo.
Y envíen un nuevo archivo.
La segunda, la producción de que está en el estudio.
No lo entendí, puedo volverlo a repetir.
Ok, aprovechando que estaba en Schoology, ¿dónde podemos ver las clases de nuevo?
Ah, ok, aquí está. Desde su computadora, ¿verdad? ¿O desde su teléfono?
Desde la computadora.
Vale, en la computadora aquí está una carpeta que dice Zoom Video Conferences. Y aquí están los links de las clases que hemos tenido. Usted le da clic a la, digamos, le clic a la segunda.
La segunda.
Y lo va a dirigir a YouTube. Y ahí está el video ya. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Ahí está la grabación. Ahí se van a ver con las cámaras apagadas.
Nos vamos a escuchar.
No solo se van a escuchar. No, ahí van a ver cómo aparece... porque a mí me aparece de una forma, ahí a mí me aparecen todos sus nombres, aunque no tenga las caritas, pero cuando se hace la grabación, solo salen las personas que tienen su cámara encendida. ¿Más preguntas? ¿Tenemos a Douglas?
Sí, ¿dónde hay una alerta o en dónde se puede ver cuando ha finalizado la tarea o el periodo de la tarea?
No le alerta, le da una alerta cuando las tareas ya están activas y usted tiene el calendario ahí donde dice upcoming. O sea que usted tiene que estar
metiendo. ¿Y cómo se puede saber si ha caducado?
No, si ha caducado, usted entra y ve las fechas, usted tiene que revisar.
Ah, ok.
Entonces, yo le digo, ya puede hacer las tareas, entonces usted entre a revisar las fechas. Y ahí, aquí, en su perfil le va a salir, ¿ve? Usted entra aquí a su perfil y en upcoming, aquí tengo que darle yo refresh, pero ustedes, cuando ustedes entran, aquí les aparece ya las cosas que están por venir. Entonces, ahí tienen las fechas, usted sabe cuándo las tiene que entregar.
Ok.
More questions? More questions? No?
No.
No more questions? Ok. Si tiene, en el caso que tuvieron ustedes problemas haciendo la tarea, los que ya la habían hecho, ustedes mándenme un mensaje. A veces no puedo contestar de inmediato porque estoy en otras clases, pero en algún momento del día yo les voy a contestar. Entonces, para que ustedes
me siento engañada.
Hacer sus tareas. Mándeme un mensaje y yo les ayudo.
Me siento engañada porque le mandé un mensaje hasta ahorita no me ha contestado. Fue el domingo pasado.
Mire, mi WhatsApp tiene 100 y tantos mensajes ahorita. Que estoy un poquito desquiciada, pero ya le voy a revisar su mensaje. Disculpe que no se lo haya contestado. Ok, vamos a ver.
Yo se lo mandé a las 12 de la noche y me contestó.
O mejor escriban en el grupo, porque el grupo seguro lo voy a contestar más rápido que un mensaje privado.
No, en el grupo lo mandé, la verdad.
En el grupo lo mandé. Sí. Estamos peor todavía. Ah, pues no lo vi, sinceramente no lo vi. Ok, bueno.
Ay, ya está hecho.
Si no tienen más preguntas, vamos a tomar la asistencia.
Ok.
Ok, let's see. Ok, Aldo Aguirre.
Present.
Genaro Alvarenga.
Here.
Ok, Tirsa Arevalo. It's not here, right? Ok, Rodrigo Cardona. Karen Seas.
Here.
Marco, falta, teacher. Douglas Arevalo.
Douglas.
Okay. Es que a Tirsa le puso presente.
Ay,
creo.
Sí, es cierto. Eso
no. No. Ajá. No,
al revés era. Acá. Ahí. Estamos bien. Perfecto.
Douglas está.
Here.
Okay. Karen Seas.
Here.
Eduardo Contreras.
Here.
Okay. John William Cruz.
Here.
Olga Escobar.
Here.
Vamos a ver, Beatriz Garay.
Present.
Griselda González.
Present.
Jorge Luis Hernández.
Present.
Rosemary Herrera. Ah, Rosemary, yo la vi por acá, no sé si todavía está. Quizás ha tenido problemas de conexión, pero aquí estaba. Ok, César López.
Present.
Ok, Medardo Luna.
Present.
Elizabeth Martínez.
Present.
Emily Melgar.
Here.
Leonel Merino.
Present.
Jason Molina. Jason. No Jason today. Okay. Francisco Murillo.
Here.
Okay. And Celia Ortiz. Okay. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you for your time. See you on Monday. Have a great weekend.
Okay.
Bye.
Good weekend for everybody.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Have a good one.
Bye.